This is the No Bull Sessions podcast, hosted by Richard Bull. Feel the music and enjoy discussions about some of the greatest songs of our time. Just music, no bull.
Yeah, all right. So today we're going to talk about Leonard Cohen and his awesome song, Hallelujah. Besides talking about the song, we're also going to listen to it. We're going to listen to different sections of the song, talk a little bit music theory, talk about the lyrics and all kinds of cool stuff. So let's talk a little bit about Leonard Cohen. He began as a poet and then a novelist. He wasn't really making enough money doing that, and it developed into a singer-songwriter music career. He was a Jewish boy from Montreal, Canada, raised pretty religious. He went on to study like a lot of religions, and he actually became a Zen Buddhist monk, like an ordained Buddhist monk. Pretty cool. He studied for about 30 years. This man traveled the world, and he's just like one of those cool guys that like hung out with all those bohemian folks from New York to all over Europe and all over the world. So he was really well-respected, well-liked, and very, very talented. He traveled the world. He had this huge, full, complete life. By the way, Montreal, my brother lived in Montreal for about a year. And when I went to visit him, he's like, hey, let's go to Moishe's. It's awesome. Moishe's is basically Moses in Hebrew. So Moishe's is this really great steak restaurant in Montreal. So we hung out there and the food was excellent. And that happened to be like one of like the top spots for Leonard Cohen. And I didn't know that at the time. I know that now. And I think that's a little cool tidbit. So the song is featured on the album Various Positions from 1984. And the record label actually didn't want to put it out. They were like, listen, this is just not good enough. We don't like the material. And little do you know, it had the biggest hit of Leonard Cohen's career and one of the biggest songs in the world. It's a very, very impactful song, as you will hear pretty soon. And it was covered by hundreds of artists, one of them being Bob Dylan. And at one point, Cohen was talking to Bob Dylan. He's like, man, this took me 2 years to write. It was like a labor of love. It was so intense. It was so important for him. He really wanted to write this great, amazing song. And he just put like everything into it. I mean, he has hundreds and hundreds of songs, but this one took such an immense amount of effort and thinking and meditating to get it to where it was. He wrote 80 different verses for the song. So he finally settled on like 15 verses for the full length entirety song, which is not the one we're going to listen to because that'll take a little too long. The one that we have is the basic version. It's about 4.5 minutes. And it includes the 4 main verses to the song. The song is featured in countless TV shows and in a bunch of movies like Watchmen, Shrek, Feast of Love, Lord of War. I mean, so many. Now, when we listen to the song, what I want to ask you guys is, if you're not driving or doing anything like that, put some headphones on. This song is just, the structure is just verse, chorus, verse, chorus, verse, chorus, and that's it. And if you really get into it, it's kind of like this meditative trance of a song. It's amazing on so many levels, lyrically, musically. So I think I've said enough. I think it's time we listen to this awesome song. I hope you enjoy it. Here we go. Hallelujah.
Now I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah.
Isn't that awesome? I just love that bass line, the way it drives through the whole song, the crescendo through the verses, and then it just drops down and explodes again with the chorus. It's really, really cool. So now we're going to get into some of the artist covers. As you know, there's been so many different versions, so many incredible artists that have covered this song. Just to name a few, we have Katie Lang, John Cale, formerly from Velvet Underground, Willie Nelson, Jeff Buckley, Bob Dylan, Bon Jovi, Bono from U2. Probably the most famous one is the Jeff Buckley one. So we're going to take a listen to this one next. And then we're going to listen to Willie Nelson's version. And after this, we're going to go through like the biblical interpretations of the lines and the sacred key of David and the David chord. Go into a little bit of music theory and have a little bit of fun with this. You'll see. You'll like it. All right, so we're just going to show like a quick section of the Jeff Buckley song. It's so raw. I mean, it's just like this electric guitar and him. You can tell it's a live recording. It's awesome, obviously. That's why it's so big. And I just love the way he phrases his voice and just like the emotion and feeling and the way he connects and suspends his vocal line and that melody through Hallelujah.
Maybe there is a God above, but all I've ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody who I drew, yeah. It's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a call and it's a broken hallelujah.
Damn, can you feel that? It's like he's like hardly hanging on to that thread and that line and that melody, and he makes it through. I mean, the feeling is just so authentic. It's Unbelievable. Love it. Well, now we're going to listen to another amazing version, which is by Willie Nelson. And it's got this country feel, and it's also just absolutely beautiful song. So I hope you guys enjoy this one, too.
Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair. Broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Now we're ready to get into so much deep stuff. So the biblical lines and their interpretations are so intense. There's so many different layers of the interpretations. There's that, you know, direct biblical lines that you can take. There's those broken hallelujahs, those beautiful hallelujahs, the perfect, the imperfect, you know, the literal, the sexual, the biblical. There's so much to take from this. It's really interesting. So the first verse really focuses on something that I'm absolutely into. It's all about music theory, the key of David. This song is all in C major. And we talk about, you know, the fourth, the fifth. And I want to go into that. I'll bring out my guitar so we can go through that together. And there's just so much in there. And we're not going to get into all of it, obviously, in this episode. Again, there will be a different podcast episode with an expert guest that's going to talk to us about, you know, the different frequencies, the frequency of the earth, the frequency of the universe, 432 megahertz and or hertz, actually. And there's just so many other pieces of information there that we will get to. So the first lines of the song is kind of like the secret chord that David played, because David, like, he was eventually King David, but he was a warrior David in the beginning, and he would like soothe King Saul with his special harp. He was an amazing musician, and he's known for like having like that secret key of David and keeping the bad spirits away. And David had this secret, this ability to tap into that supernatural or like secret code or secret key and musical key. And it seems that according to Leonard Cohen, he feels that the secret chord is C, because this whole song is composed in C major. And then when he goes into, you know, we go to the fourth, which is an F, and that's the fourth in the C scale. And then the fifth, which is a G. Again, we'll go over this when I have the guitar in a little bit. And then the minor fall and the major lift. That's really cool. Obviously, so many different meanings to that, figuratively, literally, and obviously in a musical sense. It's just a really cool play on words also. So you got amazing poetry there too.
Now I've heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah.
All right, so here's my guitar. So start with like the major and minor, okay? So I'm going to play you a major A real quick. And now I'm going to play you a minor. See how the minor is a little sadder? Back to the major. Went to minor there, right? So I don't know if you can hear the distinction and the difference, but it's definitely there. So let me just play you a little bit that progression that the chord progression, I would say, that that's used. So it goes, it goes like this. And it goes to the fourth, which I said is an F. It's an F major. So it says it goes like this with C. The fourth. Then the fifth. Then it goes to the minor fall, which the minor fall is actually an A minor. See that sadness? And then you lift it up. So it's a major lift. You go back to a major F chord. Then the baffled king, which is King David, he's composing, right? Goes to a G. And G is kind of like this king chord. So it's amazing in so many meanings to it, right? And then you go back to an E7. And then you hit the A minor. And right, that leads up to Hallelujah. So just to review it again, we're talking about so it goes like this. You see that, how it moves? Yeah, so here we go. Let's enter into another awesome verse. This one is obviously the Samson and Delilah story from the Bible. That line where he says, "From your lips she drew the hallelujah." It's so poetic. Again, really cool. So here, take a listen. All right, now check out this next verse.
You say I took the name in vain. I don't even know the name. But if I did, well, really, what's it to you? There's a blaze of light in every word. It doesn't matter which you heard. The
Yeah, I love this line. There's a lot going on with Leonard at this moment, and there's a lot of stuff in the past and the present that's going on when he's writing this line, and I think it's really cool. So he's like, yeah, I took the name in vain. How could I do that? I don't even know the name, which is true, because in the Old Testament, the Jewish Bible, you refer to like the Lord as Adonai, but the name of God, there's no real name. It's like four Hebrew letters, and it's a name that's too sacred to utter. So you can't even utter the name of God. It's not even spoken. You can refer to God as Hashem, which means like the name, but it's still not the name of God. So how can you take the name in vain if I don't even know what the name is? It's just an amazing line. I mean, just, he's like outwitting so many rabbis. It's just, I don't know, or going along with it. And he's just very thoughtful about that and very clever. And I think it's interesting. And it definitely makes you think about many things in many different ways. And as it goes on, it says, you know, every word has light. And basically, words are words, but the way you use them and the way you interpret them, that's what's important. The way, kind of emotion that you put into a word really makes the word be light or dark. Well, the lines in this next verse just feel cathartic. So, enough said. Check it out. Wrote 80 verses, and the official one has 15 verses. Each one of these verses are incredible. Think about it, just going again and again and again on a repeat. It is an absolute trance, going up and down, verse, chorus. It's just a very, very powerful, powerful composition. So in the Jeff Buckley version, there's a few verses that are not in the shortened version of the Leonard Cohen one that we played. So one of them has a somewhat sexual interpretation to it. I think it's important to point it out. So let's get into it right now. Well, this is what makes his lyrics so awesome. It's all about interpretation. You know, a lot of people feel this is, you know, like a rush, like a sexual climax. And but at the end of the day, it's the way you read it, the way you feel it. You know, what's it about? Like, is it, you know, what is it that was down below and now she's kind of grown cold and holds back on it? Is it about feelings? Is it more direct? You know, is it about a relationship that's, you know, died out? What is it really about? Is it about intimacy, passion? It feels like it could be. It feels like there's a lot going on with his partner, and then it dried up, right? Just didn't quite, it wasn't quite there anymore. And it's his sorrow over there and that he's trying to express, but maybe it's something else. And that's the beauty of these things, man. It is what you want it to be. So, yes, the song is very powerful. I hope you guys got a lot out of it. I love exploring the song. It was a great experience for me. And doing this podcast was just incredible. There's so much more that I want to say and talk about, but I think it'll be overwhelming. In the future, I'm going to, like I said, do another podcast. It's just about the Sacred Key of David and talk about these like different frequencies and different tunings and how we resonate with each other and with the planet and so forth. So that's coming up. So stay tuned for that. Keep in mind that the lyrics are completely open-ended to your interpretations, to whatever conclusions you draw from it are correct and they're yours. This is just, you know, my take on it. And it doesn't matter, man. It's just about enjoying the music and feeling it and interpreting it in your own way. And loving music because it's super powerful. And if you close your eyes and you put on your headphones and you listen to it again and again, you will see how this will transport you to a different place. And music is a powerful thing. you guys know, the podcast is available where all podcasts are: Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Stitcher, Spotify, everywhere. So make sure you check it out. So when Cohen was asked about like the song's meaning, he says, explains that many kinds of hallelujahs do exist, and all the perfect and broken hallelujahs are of equal value. So there you go. This is not a black and white type of thing. This is Leonard Cohen, and that's why he's a poet. He's an artist, man. So for me, it's a song about love, faith, sex, betrayal, conquest, failure, redemption. It's just life, man. And it's just music.
This has been the No Bull Sessions podcast, hosted by Richard Bull, found on Instagram at Richard Bull Toro. Make sure to comment on this podcast or leave us a voice note to be featured on future podcasts. We'll see you next time on the No Bull Sessions podcast. Just music, no bull.